Hi there, everybody. Today's topic is binary form. It takes two parts to make a binary form. Not just me and you, but A and B, the A and B sections, which we're going to learn about now. So there are two main parts to this lesson. In the first part, we'll discuss and define binary form. And in the second part, we'll look at some pieces that are in binary form. So if a piece of music has two main parts, then we say it's in binary form. It has an A part and a B part. But if a piece of music has three main parts, ABA, we say it has ternary form. Binary form is particularly common in music from the Baroque period. Dances such as the Allemande, the Courant, the Sarabande, and the Jig will always have two parts in them. These occur in Baroque dance suites. And the two halves of binary form are usually repeated, so we can call this two reprise binary. Those repeat signs in the score will make it fairly easy to find the beginnings of the two parts. So here's a summary of binary form, an A part repeated and a B part repeated. Now here are some other characteristics of binary form. You might find that the two parts are quite contrasting, or they might have similar materials. They might even be based on the same thematic ideas. The two parts can be about the same length, and we call that symmetrical binary, or one part might be longer than the other part, and then that's asymmetrical. Normally, if they're not the same length, it's the B part that's the longer part. The first part of it, if it's harmonically complete, meaning it ends with an authentic cadence in the home key, then we call it a sectional binary. But if the first part is harmonically incomplete, it doesn't end in the home key, then it's continuous binary, because the piece needs to continue in order for it to reach the home key again. And that's actually the most common type of binary form, where it moves in the first section away from the home key, and then in the second section, the second part moves back towards the tonic. Okay, so here's an example from one of the unaccompanied cello suites by Bach. This is unaccompanied cello suite number 1 in G major, and this is a minuet from that. We'll listen to this. Here's the A part. Now the A part is repeated. See that both parts are repeated, so we can call this two reprise binary. The next thing you notice is that the second half is much longer than the first half, so this one is asymmetrical binary. Pause it there. You see that the first half ends in D with a pack or with a half cadence in G, while the second part ends solidly in the key of G. So this is continuous binary, meaning the first half moves away from the home key and the second half returns to it. Now there are two other terms that are associated with binary. One is rounded binary. If the beginning of the A part returns somewhere during the B part, then we call it a rounded binary form. So to be rounded, there should be some clear return of the A part, and it should be in the original key. Sometimes this is rounded binary is described as A, and then in the second part, B, and half of A, because often the half of the A part is returning in the B part. But in some cases, even all of the A part might return in the B part. But we shouldn't confuse rounded binary with ternary, which is A, B, A, because there are just two repeated parts. You can see here's the first part, and here's the second part. Not three separate parts. A just returns within the B. So that's rounded binary. Now if the ending of the A part returns at the end of the B part, then we're going to call that balanced binary form. So if the beginning comes back somewhere in B, that's rounded. If the ending of the A part returns in B, then it's balanced. If neither of these things happens, if none of the A part returns in the B part, it's just simple binary form. Okay, here are two other examples from the Bach cello suite that show these two types of binary. And they're actually both bourrées, which is a type of French dance. Here's bourrée number 2 from the fourth cello suite. Okay, the A part is repeated. Here's the B part. And then, as the second half of the B part, all of the A returns. Right? So this is going to be called rounded binary, because we have a return of the A part, the beginning of the A part, and in fact all of the A part returning within the B part. Okay, now the second bourrée number 1, is from the third cello suite, and a different thing is happening here. Okay, we repeat the A part. Now listen to this closing gesture, because that's coming back at the end of the B part. Notice the B part is moving away from the home key of C major. Various sequences. And here's the closing gesture. That's the same as the ending of the A part. So this is a balanced binary. The endings are using the same material. Okay, so that's all the terminology that you need to know to deal with binary form, and you're ready to take the quiz that follows.